To God be the glory. I'm O.W. Prince, and this is your real illuminating moment. Are you stirring up trouble for a fellow child of God, or are you covering over their shame and humiliation? I try never to participate in another's shame. If anything, we are compelled by love to cover up their shame, that is to say, their offenses. I didn't always know this, but now I practice it. This does not conflict with God's instructions to expose sin. Sin is the transgression of Yahweh's law, whereas shame is a very personal and regrettable embarrassment and humiliation to its victim. To expose another's offenses, that is to say their shame, is to add to their humiliation and pain. This is wicked and disrespectful of God and his victim, and is most certainly against the holiness of God. Let's not forget that Yahweh knows the very intent of our hearts, and if he desired to expose us, we couldn't stand, and there would be nothing that we could do about it, and no place that we could hide. Some of us will have to endure and suffer the same level of intense judgment and humiliation that we imposed upon another, but I'm hopeful that some of us will repent and try to show the love of Yahweh in our merciful kindness toward those who have been humbled by mistakes and humiliated by circumstances and are in desperate need of an understanding and loving friend. Reference the woman caught in adultery. She found a friend in Jesus. For if we desire the Lord's mercy, we must be merciful. If we desire the Lord's grace, we must be gracious. If we desire that our mistakes and offenses be forgotten and forgiven and are not held against us, well, you get the point. To God be the glory. Please reference 1 Peter 4:8. Above all, love one another deeply, because love covers over a multitude of sins. Proverbs 17:9 says, whoever conceals an offense promotes love, but he who brings it up separates friends. And Proverbs 6:16-19 records, the Lord hates six things. In fact, seven are detestable to him: arrogant eyes, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that plots wicked schemes, feet eager to run to evil, a lying witness who gives false testimony, and last but not least, one who stirs up trouble among brothers. Hatred stirs up strife, but love covers all offenses. I'm O.W. Prince, and this has been your real illuminating moment. Keep looking up.